The hour is coming and is now here, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such people to worship him. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. We have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess our faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins. And serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the depths of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, it is a people that earn their hearts, for they have not known my ways, of whom I swore in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the compass of the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers of the deep. Who shall ascend at the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, and who has not set his mind upon vanity, nor sworn to deceive his neighbor. He shall receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of those who seek him, even of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? It is the Lord, strong and mighty, even the Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O you gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Unto you, O Lord, will I lift up my soul. my God, I have put my trust in you. Oh, let me not be ashamed, neither let my enemies triumph over me. For all those who hope in you shall not be ashamed, but those who deal untruly shall be put to confusion. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me forth in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you has been my hope all the day long. Call to remembrance, O Lord, your tender mercies and your loving kindnesses, which have been from of old. I remember not the sins and offenses of my youth, but according to your mercy, think on me, O Lord, in your goodness. Gracious and righteous is the Lord, therefore will he teach sinners in the way. Those who are meek shall he guide in judgment, and those who are gentle shall he teach his way. All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. For your name's sake, O Lord, forgive my sin, for it is great. Who is the one who fears the Lord? He shall teach him in the way that he shall choose. He shall dwell at ease, and his seed shall inherit the land. The Lord reveals his secret counsel to those who fear him, and he will show them his covenant. My eyes are ever looking to the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. Turn to me and have mercy on me, for I am desolate and in misery. The sorrows of my heart are enlarged. O bring me back. O bring me out of my troubles. Look upon my adversity and misery, and forgive me all my sin. Consider my enemies, how many they are, and how they bear a tyrannous hate against me. O keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be ashamed, for I have put my trust in you. Let integrity and righteous dealing preserve me, for my hope has been in you. Deliver Israel, O God, out of all his troubles. Be my judge, O Lord, for I have walked innocently. My trust has been in the Lord, therefore I shall not fall. Test me, O Lord, and prove me. Examine my heart and my mind. For your loving kindness is ever before my eyes, and I will walk in your truth. I have not dwelt with evildoers, neither will I have fellowship with the deceitful. I have hated the company of the wicked, and will not sit among the ungodly. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, and so will I go to your altar, that I may lift up the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all your wondrous works. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house, and the place where your honor dwells. O take not away my soul with the sinners, nor my life with the bloodthirsty, whose hands are full of wickedness, and their right hand full of bribes. But as for me, I will walk innocently. O deliver me and be merciful unto me. My foot stands firm. I will praise the Lord in the congregations. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel, beginning with the 25th chapter, the first verse. Then Samuel died, and all Israel assembled and mourned for him, and they buried him at his house in Ramah. And David set out and went down to the wilderness of Paran. Now there was a man in Maon whose business was in Carmel. And the man was very rich, and he had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats. And it came about, while he was shearing his sheep in Carmel, Now, the man's name was Nabal, and his wife's name was Abigail, and the woman was intelligent and beautiful in appearance, but the man was harsh and evil in his dealings, and he was a celebrite. That David heard in the wilderness that Nabal was shearing his sheep. So David sent 10 young men, and David said to the young men, "Go up to Carmel and visit Nabal and greet him in my name. And this is what you shall say: Have a long life, peace to you, and peace to your house, and peace to all that you have. Now then, I have heard that you have shears. Now your shepherds have been with us. We have not harmed them, nor has anything of theirs gone missing all the days they were in Carmel. Ask your young men, and they will tell you. Therefore, let my young men find favor in your eyes, for we have come on a festive day. Please give whatever you find at hand to your servants and to your son David." When David's young men came, they spoke to Nabal in accordance with all these words in David's name, and they waited. And Nabal answered David's servants and said, "Who is David? And who is the son of Jesse? There are many servants today who are each breaking away from his master. Shall I then take my bread and my water and my meat that I have slaughtered for my shears and give it to men whose origin I do not know?" So David's young men made their way back and returned, and they came and informed him in accordance with all these words. Then David said to his men, "Each of you strap on his sword." So each man strapped on his sword, and David also strapped on his sword, and about 400 men went up behind David, while 200 stayed with the baggage. Now one of the young men told Abigail, Nabal's wife, saying, "Behold, David sent messengers from the wilderness to greet our master, and he spoke to them in anger. Yet the men were very good to us, and we were not harmed, nor did anything go missing, as long as we went with them while we were in the fields. They were a wall to us both by night and by day, all the time we were with them tending the sheep. Now then, be aware and consider what you should do, because harm is plotted against our master and against all his stronghold. And he is such a worthless man that no one can speak to him." And Abigail hurried and took 200 loaves of bread and 2 jugs of wine and 5 sheep already prepared and 5 measures of roasted grain and 100 cakes of raisin and 200 cakes of figs. And she loaded them on donkeys. Then she said to her young men, "Go on ahead of me. Behold, I am coming after you." But she did not tell her husband Nabal. And it happened as she was riding on her donkey and coming down by the hidden part of the mountain, that behold, David and his men were coming down toward her. So she met them. Now David had said, "It is certainly for nothing that I have guarded everything that this man has in the wilderness, so that nothing has gone missing of all that belonged to him. For he has returned to me evil for good. May God do so to the enemies of David, and more so if by morning I leave alive as much as one male of any who belong to him." When Abigail saw David, she hurried and dismounted from her donkey and fell on her face in front of David and bowed herself to the ground. She fell at his feet and said, "On me alone, my lord, be the blame, and please let your slave speak to you and listen to the words of your slave. Please do not let my lord pay attention to this worthless man Nabal, for as his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and stupidity is with him. But I, your slave, did not see the young men of my lord whom you sent. Now then, my lord, as the Lord lives, and as your soul lives, since the Lord has restrained you from shedding blood and from avenging yourself by your own hand, now then, may your enemies and those who seek evil against my lord be like Nabal. And now, let this gift which your servant has brought to my lord be given to the young men who accompany my lord. Please forgive the offense of your slave, for the Lord will certainly make for my lord an enduring house, because my lord is fighting the battles of the Lord, and evil will not be found in you all your days. Should anyone rise up to pursue you and to seek your life, then the life of my lord shall be bound in the bundle of the living with the Lord our your God. For the lives of your enemies he will sling out as from the hollow of a sling. And when the Lord does for my Lord in accordance with all the good that he has spoken concerning you, and appoints you ruler over Israel, this will not become an obstacle to you or a troubled heart to my Lord, both by having shed blood without cause and by my Lord's having avenged himself. When the Lord deals well with my Lord, then remember your slave. Then David said to Abigail, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who sent you this day to meet me, and blessed be your discernment, and blessed be you, who have kept me from this day from bloodshed and from avenging myself by my own hand. Nevertheless, as the Lord lives, as the Lord of Israel lives, who has restrained me from harming you, if you had not come quickly to meet me, there certainly would not have been left to Nabal until the morning light as much as one meal." So David accepted from her hand what she had brought him, and said to her, "Go up to your house in peace. See, I have listened to you and granted your request." Then Abigail came to Nabal, and behold, he was having a feast in his house, like the feast of a king. And Nabal's heart was cheerful within him, for he was very drunk. So she did not tell him anything at all until the morning light. But in the morning, when the wine had gone out of Nabal, his wife told him these things, and his heart died within him, so that he became like a stone. About 10 days later, the Lord struck Nabal, and he died. When David heard that Nabal was dead, he said, "Blessed be the Lord who has pleaded the cause of the shame inflicted on me by the hand of Nabal, and has struck back his servant from evil. The Lord has also returned the evil doing of Nabal on his own head." Then David sent a proposal to Abigail to take her as his wife. When the servants of David came to Abigail at Carmel, they spoke to her, saying, "David has sent us to you to take you to him as his wife." And she got up and bowed with her face to the ground and said, "Behold, your slave is a servant to wash the feet of my lord's servant." Then Abigail got up quickly and rode on a donkey with her 5 female attendants who accompanied her. And she followed the messengers of David and became his wife. David had also taken Ahinoam of Jezreel, and they both became his wives. But Saul had given his daughter Michal, David's wife, to Palti, the son of Laish, who was from Galib. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us glorify the Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. In the firmaments of his power, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. A reading from St. Paul's Epistle to the Romans, beginning with the 6th chapter, the 1st verse. What shall we say then? Are we to continue in sin so that grace may increase? Far from it. How shall we who died to sin still live in it? Or do you not know that all of us who have been baptized unto Christ Jesus has been baptized into his death? Therefore we have been buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, so we too may walk in newness of life. For if we have become united with him in the likeness of his death, certainly we shall also be in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old self was crucified with him, in order that our body of sin may be done away with, so that we would no longer be slaves to sin. For the one who has died is freed from sin. Now, if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him, knowing that Christ, having been raised from the dead, is never to die again. Death no longer is master over him. For the death that he died to sin once for all time. But the life that he lives to God. So you too consider yourselves dead to yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, sin is not to reign in your mortal body, so that you obey its lusts, and do not go on presenting the parts of your body to sin as instruments of unrighteousness, but present yourselves to God as those who are alive from the dead, and your body parts as instruments of righteousness for God. For sin shall not be master over you, for you are not under the law, but under grace. What then, are we to sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? Far from it. Do you not know that the one to whom you present yourselves as slaves for obedience, you are slaves of that same one whom you obey, either of sin resulting in death or of obedience resulting in righteousness? But thanks be to God that though you were slaves of sin, you became obedient from the heart to that form of teaching to which you were entrusted. And after being freed from sin, you became slaves to righteousness. I am speaking in human terms because of the weakness of your flesh. For just as you presented the parts of your body as slaves to impurity and to lawlessness, resulting in further lawlessness, so now present your body's parts as slaves to righteousness, resulting in sanctification. For when you were slaves of sin, you were free in relation to righteousness. Therefore, what benefit were you then deriving from the things of which you are now ashamed? For the outcome of those things is death. But now, having been freed from sin and enslaved to God, you derive your benefit resulting in sanctification, and the outcome, eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gracious gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. You are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. He was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour down upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, who after the creation of the world rested from all your works and sanctified a day of rest for all your creatures, grant that we, putting away all earthly anxieties, may be duly prepared for the service of your sanctuary, and that our rest here upon earth may be a preparation for the eternal rest promised to your people in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise. Not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen.